Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. Pranams to everyone. Thanks for the intro, sir. Very happy to meet you in this session, morning session. Everybody is unite with a common purpose for this journey. Before we start our journey, just let me recap the last week's session. I think the last 2 weeks session was handled by our Muthu sir. Do you know, anybody can recall the topic what we discussed? Yeah, sleep. It was a wonderful topic, sleep and Vedatriyam. The scientific concepts were wonderfully linked, and Muthu sir gave his personal experience with a lot of practical demonstration how sleep and Vedatriyam is linked. I think many people benefited with those topics. So now let us start our journey. Today I'm very happy to share a small concept of our Vedatriyam linked with journey of consciousness. When we say journey, there are two titles here: journey of consciousness. When we say journey, it is having a plan, correct? Normally, when we say we are planning for a vacation or a journey to a trip, what amount of time we spend for that planning, where to start, how to prepare, so where to reach, what are the modes of transport we need to follow. So there are many things we need to plan, correct? The same with small sense of our human life, we plan our journey. How the consciousness traveled a lot with the purpose of attaining the realization. That journey we are going to discuss. Today, the session, we are going to understand what is consciousness, what is the relationship, the consciousness with the truth and divinity, and the truth seekers, their experience and explanations about this consciousness, and our Vedatri Maharshi, how he simplified this realization to follow in our daily routine life. So let us start to understand the consciousness. The human birth, when we say the human birth, our birth has there is a purpose for our birth to this world. The purpose of our life is leading a happy life, attaining the realization. That was one of the goal of our birth, the desire to realize the divine states. It resides in each and every individual, but everybody is attaining this? There are many truth seekers, they realize, understand, and try to give their own versions, but because of the theory, there are many flaws. People do not accept, and it was eroded. But now, with the modern science, when you say science, people really, with the modern theories, they are ready to accept the practical challenges, and the consciousness, the spirituality can be easily explained. So our Maharshi took this as a special tool to realize the spiritual journey for the realization. Basically, the consciousness, when you explain what exactly the consciousness means, it is the order of function in everything and everywhere. I will start with some of the truth seekers' explanation. Everybody knows Thiruvalluvar. There is a great famous poet in Tamil saying. In his poem about the consciousness, he says, "Ayyappadathu agathathu unarvaanai deivathodu oppakkalal eppurul ethanmai thaayinum appurul meipurul kaanbadarivu." The English version is, whatever thing of whatsoever kind it be, it is the wisdom spot in each very thing to see. So consciousness is wisdom. So whatever thing and whatsoever the kind, it is the one filled everywhere. The same thing Vivekananda says, worship God in man. So the divine realization, God realization will happen in man when we start understanding the consciousness and worshipping within man. The very same consciousness was explained beautifully in Vedas by Vedic seekers, Prajnanam. That was the Brahman. Consciousness is the almighty truth. That is the explanation for Prajnanam. The another theory is the Tattvamasi. You are the divinity. That is the explanation for Tattvamasi. The another Vedic explanation is Aham Brahmasmi. The inner soul becomes the divinity. So like this, there are many truth seekers. They say, my body is temple of consciousness. So no need to go search everywhere. Your body itself is the temple of consciousness. This was one of the theory about consciousness. Why this realization is required? Maharshi says, in a simple example, take a pot, empty pot, and try to, it is an empty pot, you are trying to immerse in the water. So what will happen? So water will go inside and disappears, correct, into the water. So likewise, if your consciousness, when it operates with the sensory perceptions, it loses its identity. When the same part, if we keep it upside down, water will, it will rise back and throw out of water, correct? When you keep it upside down, it try to float about for the freedom. Similarly, when we realize the consciousness and its origin, so the sensory perception will not pull you down. It will not take you to the downside. So being in the state of constant awareness, it would be helpful to reach back to the nature, the infinite consciousness. When we say the journey, it starts from at one place and it moves on. How we can understand this? Take a ocean. The ocean is very big. We can imagine, correct? So the same ocean, because of the evaporation, the water droplets rise above and become cloud. So at what particular controlled temperature, the cloud becomes a wonderful rain, and rain pours everywhere. So it becomes pond, river, then it starts its journey again. Where it goes again? The river, the very same water after evaporation becomes river again. It starts its journey to reach the ocean finally. Unless it reaches the ocean, it will not stop. The very same example you can apply for our consciousness. In the human, we have our own sixth sense. This sixth sense is allowing us to think back where from we evolved, where are we, how we come back with the tool of assumptions. So we use the assumption as a tool to understand the realization of this journey. Now let us slowly go in little deep where the divine state is stuck. For the divine state, when I say consciousness, it is the very basic truth we can directly relate with divinity. So understanding the divinity itself is understanding the consciousness. According to our Maharshi philosophy, the divine state, it has four basic characteristics and three basic capabilities. Let us go one by one. What are those characteristics and what are the capabilities of our divinity? The basic four characteristics start with the name of plenum. The first one is plenum, then second one is force, the third one is consciousness, and fourth one is time. So we see consciousness is one of the very basic characteristics of the divine state. We'll start with the plenum. What is plenum? The divine state is infinite. So whatever we see, the visible objects with all four dimensions, the volume, time, distance, whatever, it all originates from the divine state. But it remains undiminished, and everything is in the universe only. It is omnipresent everywhere, omnipotent. We call it as omnipotent. So we, in the Sanskrit, we call it as Puranam, the absolute, very absolute. So it will not reduce. So whatever you take, it is always with full of Puranam. That is called Plenum. The second characteristic is the force. Now we see we are in a small earth. We are living in a small planet. But when you think the universe, the very big universe with millions of stars and galaxies, where we are. So the earth revolves the sun around 15 lakh miles per day. So when you check the solar system, it has a wonderful force. It has its own force. What this force, where from it comes, is the absolute space. It has its own self-compressive surrounding pressure force. We call it as a self-compressive surrounding pressure force. The same absolute space, which was vacuum, but because of its own compression, the chromatic quirring starts and it starts moving. So that force is called self-compressive surrounding pressure force. The same pressure helps us to develop the millions of stars, planets, galaxies in the very vast universe. Now, the third quality is the consciousness. When we say consciousness, everything in the universe is characterized with the pattern, precision, and regularity. These are the three basic controls that structures every quality of a thing. So the divine state is the order of those three functions: pattern, precision, and regularity. So each and every the matter, whatever we see outside, it has this consciousness. So when we say is only animate things are having consciousness, no, even inanimate things also has the consciousness. These are the three basic principles on that. Now the fourth characteristic is the time. When I say time, it is the divine state made up of force, that beyond every force, we can say. So when we say chromatic quirring, the motion, the constant contraction and expansions happen by the absolute space, the interval between these two querying motion, that we say as a time. The same absolute space compress its own and expands. So this time difference, we call it as time, divine time. All these changes in the universe are happening because of this quality of time. Now let us go understand the few capabilities of the divine. Capability, when we say the same divine now has the capability into three different capability. That is the self-transformation, the first one. The second one is the mutation. The third one is the cause and effect. These are the three capabilities for the divine state. What is self-transformation? As the journey starts, the divine, with a very basic formative dust, the dust formed in the beginning, the association of this formative dust, we call it as an energy particle. When these energy particles associate together, then the panchabhutas came, the non-living things, then followed by the living things. The final stage of this transformation is our consciousness in the living things. We call it as our sixth sense. So the total consciousness is with the absolute space, and the fractional consciousness is within us. So the evaluation starts with this transformation and it goes on. That is the reason Vedatrayam refers this process of change is the divine state of transformation, self-transformation. Then we'll understand, try to understand the mutation capability. What is mutation? Now the mutation transforms our life form with the sensory perceptions, start with the one sense life to slowly develop with two sense, three sense, finally to a sixth sense as a human. Start with the plant, correct? It has the one sense, appears on the earth. So this series of mutation happened on the plant, then it slowly developed to the second sense as worms, third sense as insects, then fourth sense as reptiles, then fifth sense as animal, finally become the wonderful human is evolved. So this mutation is also one of the capability of the divine. Now the third capability is the cause and effect. It is also a very basic thing of a divine capability. It is the law of cause and effect. The awareness of the universe, the manifestation of desire, the divine state, every actions has an equal and opposite reaction, correct? So that basic fundamental we everybody know with the support of science. So God realization will happen when we understand this very fundamental concept of capability. Whatever we do, the effects follows with the same cause. So achieving the purpose of human life will happen only when we start understanding these four capabilities. Now in the inanimate objects, as I told before, the consciousness works as pattern, precision, regularity, correct? The pattern is the one, every object has its own space, depends upon the quantity and quality, the association. It has a length, breadth, depth of particular object, correct? So the association forms multiple, multiplies, and the energy particles develop, and beyond the level of sensory perception, it becomes forms and become a human life to perceive through our senses. But in an inanimate form, it is the same as a work as a pattern. Precision, when I say precision, it is also an inborn quality of divine, works in the inanimate objects as a character. The quality of this object also depends on the quantity and quality, and as well as the functions of energy particles that comprise. When you say a knife is an inanimate object, it has millions of energy particles, correct? So the same knife, you can use it for cutting, chopping. So precision has a very basic function. It reflects in the individual nature of an object, also in the living thing. Now, the regularity. The regularity is another function of consciousness in the inanimate object. It is the one changes are brought about by individual action and transformed into chain reaction. The shape and quality of a stone or any object, the particles contain it. So the regularity of nature, the growth of the paddy or the sprouts, it whatever the age, which time it has to grow, what is the next cycle it has to be cut. So the same way a child growth in mother's womb, at the age of 10th month, it has to come out to the life. After the birth, it slowly start functioning as a order of function. So we call it as this as a regularity. Now, in the animate things, living things, the same, very same consciousness works as three functions. It is the cognitions, experience, and discrimination. So what is cognitions? It is the very basic process. Because of the magnetic waves, the biomagnetism within the body, it produces vibration. So this same biomagnetism affects the circulation within the body. So this wave is called, we call it as cognition. Biomagnetic waves emanates within the body. The experience, what we can understand, the same wave, when we interact with other objects, it travels to the genetic center and it stores, and we recall what was that before and how was the experience. So we compare the current experience with the past experience. So this relates to experience. Now, discrimination. Discrimination is another quality of the same, very same magnetic wave. It compares and perceives the difference between these two. It is one of the experience on the strength of our records, genetic records, which is stored inside our body. So these three, cognition, experience, and discrimination, takes place in every living thing, not only human, it happens in every living thing. All this quality for the animate, pattern, precision, regularity, and for the living things, these three, cognition, experience, discrimination, all these qualities together forms to the next level. So with this understanding, the journey of consciousness starts with the purpose to achieve the realization. And what exactly Maharshi says, he gave us a package, a wonderful sky yoga practice to get into this realization. So how he gave this wonderful practical model using the scientific support, there are very basic things. He started with the fundamental physical fitness, for the body to get the physical fitness, he gave physical exercise. For the life force which circulates within the body, for that he gave us a kayakalpa yoga for that practice. So the fundamental practice for physical fitness and the life force fitness, he gave us two practicals. Now for the realization, self realization, he gave us meditation. So the meditation is one of the very basic tool, though there are many truth seekers gave this, but our meditation is very simplified, and even common man can achieve this realization when he show interest and start understanding this concepts. He gave different meditations, start from focusing our life energy with the mind. So mind and life energy is getting connected in our meditation, and we are able to realize. So he takes us to a step one by one. Then he gave us the topic of introspection, with to improve the relationship with self as well as to others. So he start with the thought, realization of thought, then desire management, then anger management, moralization of desire, anger management, finally eradication of worry. Step by step he takes us to this journey, and at the end he give us a wonderful topic to get the perfection, the self realization as who am I. So even the very basic philosophy of life, he says the development of knowledge with three stages. Start with faith, understanding, and realization. So the early age, when we are not with that with the limited knowledge, when we are as a childhood, we start with the faith. So the realization will happen slowly. Once the faith will get clarified with some understanding by knowing and experience, then that understanding will take you to the next step of realization. So this was the knowledge development on the human evolution. So this perfection as a self-enquiry, normally this realization happens with the question of who am I. We used to hear the words who are you, answering asking a question to another person, who are you. But when you say the same question as who am I, then it is the self enquiry. It will take you to the next question, who is God. So when we ask this question, then our journey starts inward. The greatness of the noblest presence of our consciousness within our human life can be realized by start asking this question. This gives us the life realization. With proper practice, one can understand how God is within us, how the divinity is merged with us. That realization can be understood with this question. There are some definitions with this realization. Whatever you see, the animate things, this is also association of energy particle, and whatever living things you see outside, that is also a form of the same thing of divinity. So even in our Maharishi's prayer song, we follow this consciousness. How we relate this consciousness in our prayer song? The Almighty God is present everywhere without any absence. we cannot just believe on word. Who is the action in every energy of an atom, and it is the harmonious blend of that atom, V. So there is no difference between V and divinity. So if we forget the divinity, we are very small. So if we understand the same divinity, then we feel proud and big. So the place where we understand the human self and divinity as one, the consciousness is complete. That is the liberation. So with this understanding, I conclude my speech. The journey of consciousness, it starts with the purpose and function as a consciousness in the human thing to attain the liberation. Thanks to everyone. Thank you, sir. Thank you all.